An impending vote is dividing this Scarborough community as two schools in need of major repairs in Guildwood Village are fighting to get funding to get their schools rebuilt. But that'll only happen if the TDSB closes two other schools. Now that's pit neighbor against neighbor, parents against parents in the battle over tens of millions of dollars.
They're pitting the neighborhood against each other.
TDSB staff found enrollment at Guildwood Junior Public School, which has classes from JK to 6th grade, declined by 49%. In the last 10 years. And enrollment has also been on the decline at Jack Minor Senior Public School, a grade 7 and 8 school. Right now it's sitting at half empty. A report that went to a TDSB committee put forward 9 recommendations, including closing the two schools, then rebuilding nearby Elizabeth Simcoe School and Poplar Road Junior Public School. Both would also be converted to include students from the other schools.
Everybody's fighting, everybody's, you know, now it's ruined a beautiful community over something like this, the promise of a shiny new build at the expense of the students of Guildwood Junior Public School.
9 trustees voted on Monday, the majority of which were against the recommendations.
We don't feel that they had a chance to even review those delegations. They heard the verbal delegations at the meeting.
Approximately $35 million will get pumped into rebuilding their schools, money the TDSB doesn't have yet, but will have to request from the Ministry of Education.
There's only one opportunity that we have as a community, as a school board, to be gifted this money from the government to open up these new learning facilities that would benefit generations of students to come. And if we blow it, if the school board blows it, then we'll never have a chance at this ever again.
According to the local trustee for Guildwood Village, these two schools were selected to be rebuilt because of their need for repairs. Poplar School has the highest need amongst them all.
What do we do if one of these repairs comes unplanned, unexpected? They're already identified as critical. So what does that do to the existing students, to the existing daycares that are in all three of the establishments?
He has put a motion forward for the report to go in front of all the 22 trustees for another vote.
When it's this divided, you're not going to please everybody, so you have to look at what the will of the majority of the constituents are. And it comes down to that, unfortunately.
Trustee Chadwick, who is in favor of the recommendation, says if the motion isn't approved, all four schools could be in limbo.
The committee recommendation will go forward, and therefore we're in status quo. We haven't addressed the problem of low enrollment. We haven't addressed the facilities condition index issues. Nothing has changed.
If Trustee Chadwick's motion is granted, that debate and vote could come on June 21st. And with already over 100 pages of documents submitted, this meeting is expected to be anything but quick and easy. Now, this story came to us from a City News viewer. If you see news in the making, here are all the ways you can get in touch with us. In Scarborough, I'm Faiza Amin for City News.